With inquiries into the purchase of 48 billion shilling locomotives still underway, members on the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises were left puzzled on visiting Uganda Railway Corporation workshop. They found out that 4 locomotives are still grounded 3 months after they were procured. Although URC officials had promised the committee that the new locomotives were supposed to start work on the 15th November this year, the managing director, Stanley Sendegeya, begged for another extension of 2 weeks to enable them fix the remaining works on the turning points.
We cannot just say, okay, you have said, let's move on. They must work because the taxpayer has spent a lot of money, 48 billion shillings in total and everything. They must be able to work. And if they fail to work, something has got to happen. What happens to these 48 billion shillings that the ordinary Ugandans spent on as a taxpayer?
We really got some challenges on the modifications. We thought they would be so fast, but now they've taken us longer. That's the truth about the matter. They've taken us longer, and that's the whole truth about it. They have taken us longer than we anticipated. We thought the work was little. But many of these lines have not been touched for maybe for over 30 years.
The officials told members that they have received much pressure and having sleepless nights to see that the project is implemented, but there has been a lot of challenges to get the work done on time.
We are on a lot of pressure to make those locomotives start moving now. There is too much pressure on us that we don't even sleep. Me, I've even reached the extent that my children on TV ask you, then I deny I'm not the one because of the money that is stolen. I deny.
Generally, what people want to understand is when will these locomotives begin to operate? Because they have not started to operate because of all these challenges that are outstanding. You need to modify triangles. I don't know, change certain rails somewhere, etc., etc.
Yes.
That's why we have not started to operate them.
Yes.
When will they start to operate?
The delivery contract is 31st December 2021. That supplier, see, has not delivered those locals as we speak. So we really don't know why we're on too much pressure because the supplier is still here to deliver his contract. He hasn't finished. He hasn't delivered.
Kosase also discovered that the extension of Kampala flyover by Uganda National Roads Authority has also affected the progress of the locomotives.
URC and UNLA are all government bodies, isn't it? Why don't you tell us the truth that UNLA took your land, so did so and so, they interfered with your angle of changing, so that now for us we take a political action?
Committee members who took a short drive in the controversial locomotives were also shocked to discover that the old locomotives of URC are operating without insurance cover.
You know, we have a fleet of locomotives, not only these 4. We have a fleet of locomotives. We cut out insurance, which we call goods in transit insurance. So even for these ones, we'll include them in the insurance under goods in transit.
Meaning they are not insured currently?
They are not yet ours. They are not, because I said the supplier contract is not yet delivered.
URC acquired 4 refurbished locomotives from South Africa in August this year as part of its efforts to revamp the railway transport. This story was compiled by Fred Kajiri for the news in Kampala.